of the curious oysters. The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all its might. He did his very best to make the billow smooth and bright. And this was all because it was the menu of the night. The walrus and the carpenter were walking closer then. The beach was wide from side to side, but much too full of men. "Mr. Walrus," said the carpenter, "our brine begins to lurk. We'll sweep this clear in half a year, if you don't mind the work."
"Work? The time has come," the walrus said, "talk of other things. Of shoes and ships and sealing wax and cabbages and kings. And why the sea is boiling hot and whether pigs have wings. Come, Calais, no work today. Where cabbages and kings?" Come.
Yeah, you're right. It is a sad story. I wonder where that is.
Oh, yes, a very good moral. If you happen to be an oyster, well, it's been a very nice visit.
Let's go just out. Yeah, I'm agreed. Good question, Moon. I wonder who lives there. I know that voice. You do?
I seen it.
Yeah, I seen it too. What is his problem? White. What a drama king. Let's check up this.
I suppose I'll be taking orders from Dinah next.
What are you looking for?
I'm looking for something.
Now let me see. If I were a rabbit, where would I keep my gloves?
Say so for me too! Here you go.
What if I do?
Oh, here we go again! You're white, Moon! Here we go again! Oh, no! Ah! The dodo, he's here too?
Yes, he is here.
What?
Yeah, thank goodness it's right. Try to get you out, won't he?
Only one way to find out, just now.
Nothing to it, old boy. Simply tie your tail around the monster's neck and drag it out. Good luck, Bill.
I gotta hide before it's too late. What is it, Moon?
I gotta sneeze. This isn't even worse when I turn into a flying squirrel. This isn't even worse than that.
Bless you. Moon? Bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. No, indeed. I have no idea why they gotta try to burn the house.